Hi guys, welcome back to the Doodling Web Design channel. This is Bully. Today I am going to show you guys how to install and configure a free plugin that is for a countdown timer to increase sales on your online store. This plugin is free. Before we get started, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and turn on that bell notification so you won't miss any of my new web design videos in the future. I would appreciate it. If you find this video helpful somehow, please give it a thumbs up. All right, without further ado, let's get started. Why it is very important and helpful to add a countdown timer right next to every sale product on your online store? Well, according to a survey conducted by WordPress, adding a countdown timer can increase the sales revenue as much as 9%. It's because it reminds the customers the limited amount of time that they have to get that deal. According to the Adoric blog, the main purpose of adding a countdown timer is that to create a sense of urgency and to make the customers feel that the time is running out. They have to hurry to get that deal. Also, a lot of businesses like to use this feature just to offer a certain discount item whenever that item is available. This is a free plugin and I've tried it. It works very well so far. Well, without further ado, let's find out how this plugin looks like on your online store. Let's go to my computer.
Let's go to your online store, go to plugins, add new. We are going to search for countdown timer. Install the hurry timer. This plugin is free and is a very simple timer to use on your online store. After you done installing it, click activate. Scroll down to find the countdown timer plugin to turn on the auto update. And then click on the settings. This is the general settings we want to add. Add a campaign. Name your campaign. Enter a name here. In this case, I just entered hurry up. And select on evergreen on the schedule tab. And you could set up days, hours, whatever you want here. I just add 3 hours and leave the rest the same. Over here is the click restart immediately. And then saved it. Let's go see the next tab. The next tab is for WooCommerce. In this case, I will show you guys what would happen if you turn this on to display the timer on every product page. In this case, we will add it at the above of the add to cart button. And let's go to the next tab. It's called actions. In this case, there are many options that you guys can play around with. In this tutorial, I am not going to get into those options, so we will leave it at none. Let's go to the Appearance tab right here. If you look at the top, that's how it looks like on the page right now. So we are going to go to just leave it as block, and alignment just leave it at center. It looks good, but you guys could play around the look and feel, whatever you think it will look best on your online store. There are so many options that you can customize for a free version of this plugin. We will add a content here. Right now it just hurry up, and then I wanted to add more here. You can add whatever you want right here. And I will leave the rest of the settings the same, except the color. The color of the text right here, I will change it into the red to match with my color palette for my demo online store. So I will go back to the front end to find my button color that I like to use. In this case, I am going to use a Google Chrome extension. It is a color picker extension, so I don't have to open my color template in Photoshop or as a PNG format. I just pick a color right out of my store. I am going to pick my red color from my palette and copy the hex value and paste the value right here. And then this is my color palette, and let's update it real quick. We don't want to lose our work here, just in case a disaster happens. Let's go take a look at the appearance overall. It looks like this. So it looks like the title of the content, it's a little bit too long for me. You also can add a call to action button too. It's like whenever somebody clicks on the timer, it can direct them to a page or something like that. For the custom CSS, it's a pro version. We don't want to use that because it's not free. We are going to take a look at the... Let's see. Let's go back to the content again. Right here, it's in this text box editor, it supports HTML tags. I will add a little gibberish tag of the HTML tags to add another line. It's BR in an angle bracket, and save it. And let's go to the front end to see how it looks like. Actually, we have to grab the shortcode. In this case, I will show you guys. There are two ways to add this timer. One via a shortcode. Two, under the tab WooCommerce to display on every page of your product pages. So I am going to show you how to add its short code that we just copied earlier onto a product page. I will add it into the short description of the product page, The short description section is shown on top of the page. I will toggle to the text tab to the right so I can add a little of HTML tag. Adds a line to break up the content. It's called HR. And then I just paste the short code and toggle back to the visual tab. Save or update your product page. Let's go back to the front end to refresh it to see how it's gonna look like. As you can see, the timer is displayed inside the top section of the page. I need to refresh the page and clear all the cache because I already installed a caching plugin on my demo store. So I could see all the changes that I just made. And the lie, there are two lies because I added a lie break HTML tag. And when we do the right click in that section and select inspect element, the font is 20 pixels that I just changed also. If you toggle back and forth, you will see it's back to default or it's back to the pixels that you just changed, the size that you just changed it. And let's scroll down. When you scroll down a little bit, you also see another timer display under the add to cart button. It is because we enable the WooCommerce tab. So in this case, we are going to keep just the short code. We are going back to the plugin and go back to the WooCommerce tab and turn off that tab so it won't be displayed automatically in every product page. And click the update button on the right. Let's go back to the front end and refresh the page. Oh, it's gone now. The timer underneath the add to cart is gone, and then we have only the one that we wanted, which is on top of the page. It looks good so far. That's it.
That's all for this tutorial. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't yet, and give this video a thumbs up if you find it helpful somehow. Leave me a comment below which plugin that you guys like to use to add a countdown timer. I would love to hear from you guys a lot. I always appreciate your support and for being here watching my video. I wish you all have a wonderful day wherever you are. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye now.